Portugal. I want to take you guys now down to Miami. I'm assuming this is out of Miami. That's what it said in the email. This video footage was sent in by Terry Scar. I don't know if you guys have seen this making the rounds. This is the first time I've ever even seen video footage like this. It's of some sort of a weird-looking creature. I'll leave it up to you guys to decide. I guess if it were standing, it would be somewhere in the neighborhood of 8 to 10 feet tall, quite possibly even taller. This video footage was sent in by Terry. I don't know any specifics other than that, Terry Scar. And apparently, according to Terry, this was shared with him, and it may have something to do with the incident down in Miami. That's all I know, guys. I don't have any other details other than that. Thanks for the photos and videos.
Why is he running? Let's go. Hell no.
Yo, why y'all running? What's happening?
There were aliens, yo.
Aliens?
Yes, they were black aliens.
Black aliens? Oh, maybe they friendly. Maybe we just jump into the... Oh, hell no.
Oh my God. Oh damn. Forgot my car. I ran all the way home, I forgot my car. Oh no. I can't let no alien destroy the whip. I just bought that, no.
Why it's so important to get the vaccines, because when you're unvaccinated, you can catch COVID, spread COVID, and die from it. But when you are vaccinated, you can catch COVID, spread COVID, and die from it, but you're vaccinated.
Oh.
But you're vaccinated. Guys, you're vaccinated.
Kids, how to unlock their own power.
Instead, you be your own leader. You become your own man. You unlock your own power, just like Naruto. You unlock Sage Mode. You unlock the power of a Super Saiyan.
Yeah.
By being you.
Yeah.
By being you.
Yeah.
Yes. So, y'all. So, can I count on y'all to be leaders?
Yeah.
Okay. Can I count on y'all to love yourselves?
Yeah.
Okay. I want us to do a quick activity. On the count of three, let's all say, I love who I am. One, two, three. Let's all say, I am a leader. One, two, three.
I am a leader.
Okay, on the count of three, let's all say, I am a Super Saiyan. One, two, three.
I am a Super Saiyan.
And by the way, you know, I sit on the stand and it get hot. I got hairy legs that turn. Blonde in the sun, and the kids used to come up and reach in the pool and rub my leg down so it was straight, and then watch the hair come back up again. They'd look at it. So I learned about roaches. I learned about kids jumping on my lap, and I've loved kids jumping on my lap.
The woman responsible for recommending international financial policy is Jewish. The man responsible for administering immigration law is Jewish. The man that represents America in legal matters is Jewish. 98% of the people in power positions in America is Jewish. So then they do things like this. The Anti-BDS Act, which is a law in America that states you cannot boycott against Israel. Now, is this America or is this Israel's playground? I'm gonna read to you what Israelis think about America and Americans. You know very well, and the stupid Americans know equally well, that we control their government, irrespective of who sits in the White House. You see, I know it, and you know it, that no American president can be in a position to challenge us, even if we do the unthinkable. What can they do to us? We control Congress, we control the media, we control showbiz, and we control everything in America. In America, you can criticize God, but you cannot criticize Israel.
Another video of my new findings of the Miami Mall incident. This video is slowed down 0.25. So I want you to understand how slow I have this video, because I want you to see how fast this shadow is moving. Like, I slowed it down and it's still moving fast, bro. And if you pay attention, it changes locations and it changes shapes as well. I'm gonna talk you right through it. All right, I want you to see right at the beginning, it's over here. You see how it is right there? And then look how it moves. Like, it scales over. And I want you also to think that I have this at 0.25 in time. And look how it's moving up here, right? I'm covering these guys up because you already know what time it is. I don't want to show this. But watch over my head. And you see how it moves? It moves. All right, so I want you to pay attention. Like, it moved away, right, as the camera pulls away, but it moved this way and that way before it moved away, right? So I'm thinking, where is it? Where is it, right? And then it's still back here, up here in the corner, waiting. But I want you to pay attention to what it's doing. I don't want to tell you what it's doing. I want you to see what it's doing. Look at this. Look, when he starts running over, I want you to see, look where it's at, look where it's at. Look at
that. I wonder, why do white people pay so much attention to black people if they don't like them? You would think if you didn't like something, why would you be paying attention to it? I don't pay attention to things I don't like.
What's the answer?
The answer is, the liar knows what lie he told. You see what I'm saying? So even if I made it deceitful and I made you think that the answer is over here, but the answer is really over here, I'm still going to be looking over here. Me, the one that tricked, because I know this is the right answer. Black people have lost their identity, but our oppressors have not lost our identity. That's just why they chop those noses off of the Pharaoh and the Sphinx in Egypt in the first place, is because without this nose, we can tell you this is whoever it is. But with that nose, it can only be n-s. Why would somebody vandalize a whole face and only vandalize one part? Nobody wanted to knock an eye off or take an ear off or no chins missing. No, just the nose. Because it's a brand.
It was a setup. It was a setup, kind of like a test. Project Bluebeam, no. Is that coming? Yes, let's talk about it. You guys are way too focused on the details of the situation when you're missing the point altogether. The exposure to extraterrestrials has started, and their agenda with it has started too. I'm telling you right now, the beings that they saw were real. And if you believe they're a hologram, it doesn't really change anything, because at the end of the day, the agenda with extraterrestrial disclosure is happening, the fear-based agenda that they want to happen. Look, people was running, people was afraid. The police and the military presence, they felt like they was the saviors, they felt like they were saving the day. And when police were actually questioned, they said, we can't tell you guys what's happening. And people report either their phones was glitching or they had their footage on their phone taken away. Here's some footage that's really interesting, and shout out to the person that actually made this original video. All they did was switch the coordinates from west to south, and it led them to Antarctica. You know what's going on over there. And so if we know they came through a portal, and if they came from Antarctica, that's a possibility. You guys need to understand this is part of the whole disclosure agenda. These beings were sent in just to make a little chaos, scare some people, and bounce. It was all just to make fear related to extraterrestrials. The elites, they know it's time, and you know it's time too. Their power is gone. It's disappearing. Their time is up. Now they're scrambling. You see them running to their bunkers. They're now looking for an escape route and a way of exposing the truth, which they know they have to do, in a way that keeps them in power and slows down the process of awakening on this planet. They had the agenda, oh, we want to take over the planet, have everybody under AI and all of that, have everybody under like one hive mind. But the higher vibrational agenda for Earth is that they're connected with the stars, the star people are here, everybody's consciously awakened. This is a fight between agendas for Earth. And you know what's coming, you know what's up, and it's time to get ready for it. Don't be afraid, don't fall for the tricks, know what's coming, and just be in your mode. Be in alignment with you, keep awakening, keep in your power, and allow this process to continue. Gotta die. Now let me tell you why. It's the very first breath when your head's been drowning underwater. And it's the lightness in the air when you're there chest to chest with the lover. It's holding on though the road's long and seeing light in the dark gets things. And when you stare at your reflection, finding hope and hope. I can't believe I sat through a school safety meeting, Shane, and we went over alien invasion protocols. Procedures. What to do if there's an alien invasion? Our county really gave us procedures for that. And honestly, I did not process anything that was said during that part of the presentation because I could not believe what I was looking at. Like, anybody else out there get alien invasion protocols? What to do with your students if there's an alien invasion? Just mine?
You know this. Come on now. Even for those of you who knew about Rashad Jamar, right, who just came into, you know a lot of information, and those of you who found a lot of information by knowing about Rashad Jamar, right, even Rashad Jamar told y'all about COINTELPRO. COINTELPRO is the reason why he locked up right now, but y'all don't want to believe this shit. Guess what? Coincidentally, Rashad Jamal is locked up for the same exact reasons as Malachi Z. York. You know why? Because they know that all they gotta do is say somebody did something to a kid and everybody is gonna believe them, no matter who they are. Well, if that's the case, then what the is going on with the society of the leaders who are running this show? Because we all know what they do, and ain't nobody persecuting them. Something wrong with y'all, for real. COINTELPRO, FBI, it says their whole number one mission is to prevent the coalition of militant black nationalist groups. Prevent the rise of a messiah who could unify and electrify the militant black nationalist movement. Prevent the rise of a messiah. I'm gonna read it again so you can feel this shit. They want to. Your government, they want to prevent the rise of a messiah who can unify and electrify the black community. What are you talking about? This shit is not fake. And this shit is not no conspiracy. Well, yes, it is. It is a conspiracy. Because you have motherfuckers conspiring against you. So it is a conspiracy. Because they damn sure have been conspiring against you for a very long time. Number three, though. Prevent militant black nationalist groups and leaders from gaining respectability by discrediting them to the community. This is on their top list. They do the same thing over and over again. And every time our shit just fall because of the same shit. Ain't no way. Prevent militant black nationalist groups and leaders from gaining respectability by discrediting them to the community. Ain't that what they did with Malachi Z. York? Ain't that what they did with Rashad Jamal? A final goal should be to prevent the long-range growth of militant black nationalist organizations, especially among the youth. do you hear this? And y'all, do you hear this? Their final goal is to prevent the long-range growth of militant black national organizations. So their whole goal is to stop, if you organizing, their goal is to stop you from organizing for too long. Especially if you can be the next Messiah who can lead your people to the truth. And y'all think that they don't lie on people. They've been lying on us since they got here. All they know how to do is lie. They are master deceivers. That's what they do. 135 years with not a lick of...
Leadership claimed that hundreds of members do not belong, saying that the ancestral link tying to them to the tribe was fraudulent. That fight has been going on for a decade, but today in Bellingham, several of those members face eviction and are fighting to stop it.
I'd like to argue it one more time.
A conference room inside the Bellingham Public Library served as a courtroom for disenrolled members of the Nooksack Indian tribe who are fighting to keep their homes.
I'm not understanding what's going on. When he says I'm not Native American, that my house is not Native American. My father's from Turtle Mountain Creek. My mother's from Nooksack and Squaw.
Saturnino Javier is among the so-called Nooksack 306, a group that tribal council voted to disenroll, claiming a fraudulent ancestral link to the tribe that dates back to the 19th century. This winter, dozens of members living on tribal-managed land were served eviction notices.
It's beyond stressful. You have 86 and 74-year-old elders that are not sure where they will live in a matter of days, weeks, or months.
Get him, Auntie.
86-year-old Ali Ashiro, among the three residents called before the Nooksack Housing Authority, an eviction process that has attracted global attention. Back in February, the United Nations issued a statement calling the U.S. to halt what they call imminent forced evictions of former Nooksack tribe members.
And they are at risk of losing those homes and having those homes taken without any form of compensation or recompense.
Just 2 weeks ago, the Washington State Supreme Court intervened, calling for a stop to evictions until the court has time to consider the case. Wednesday, via Zoom, proceedings continue.
I'm Native American, and that's what I am. You want to see my degree like a dog or what?
Ultimately, no decision was reached. But the Nooksack 306, today's hearing marks the next step in a procedural saga that has spanned a decade.
Now that the seal, so important, is broken, the seal is broken by what they've done. They should never have done this. This was an unwritten rule. You just don't, unless it's really bad. But you just don't. But the seal is now broken.
Now I saw when the Lamb opened one of the seals. And I heard one of the four living creatures saying with a voice like thunder, "Come and see." And I looked. And behold, a white horse. He who sat on it had a bow, and a crown was given to him, and he went out conquering and to conquer.
So I've been going down this rabbit hole recently about these 215 dead bodies that were found in unmarked graves behind a jail in Jackson, Mississippi. It's honestly insane how little media attention this is getting. And the worst part of it, in my opinion, is just the way that all of the media coverage surrounding this issue has been giving every benefit of every doubt to the police involved. One of the cases of one of the people who was found in that graveyard, Dexter Wade, was a man who was literally killed on the street by an off-duty police officer. His body was wrapped in a tarp and buried in an unmarked grave behind this prison without contacting his family. The family had no idea what happened to him or where he was for months and months. They thought he had gone missing. And his family was in constant contact with the police, trying to find him, trying to find out any information about him. And they claimed that they had no identification for him until they found him, and they literally found his wallet with his ID in his pocket. Even just the very surface level analysis that news is giving to this issue is giving so much leeway to the cops, it's insane. Because if you think about what actually happened, what happened is an off-duty police officer killed a man with his car on the freeway, wrapped his body in a tarp, and buried it in an unmarked grave like a fucking serial killer. Worse than a serial killer, because at least Jeffrey Dahmer doesn't make you pay a $250 fine to have your relative's body exhumed from an unmarked grave behind a jail. And everybody just describes this as an issue of incompetence. No, this is an issue of police accountability. This police officer killed somebody, and then all of his buddies in the police department helped cover it up in the exact same way as any other group doing organized crime. My heart goes out to all of the families who have been affected by this, and all of the families whose family members are still underground in these graves who just thought that they had gone missing. The hundreds and hundreds of people whose family members had gone missing were probably killed by police and then buried in order to cover up the evidence. Honestly, the whole thing has been very shocking to me, but unfortunately not super surprising, because when we analyze the way the police operate in other ways, it's exactly like this all of the time. It reminds me so much of that recording that got out of those two cops talking in Seattle about a woman who they had killed with one of their cars in an accident, calling her low value and saying that it didn't matter. That's the mindset that these people who are meant to protect and serve us really have towards the normal people who live in their city. They think of themselves as being gods, above impunity and above accountability. And to a much higher degree in comparison to any other group doing organized crime, they actually are above that accountability, because they are the organized crime group which we trust with figuring out who did what crime. The way that everybody's covering this is like, oh, what's going on in Jackson, Mississippi? Jackson, Mississippi is so crazy. I really think that if we start digging, we're going to find out that this is happening in lots of other places. Because why wouldn't it? The only thing that could actually stop police from doing things like this is a level of willingness to take each other accountable and care about the humanity of the people who they're meant to be protecting and serving, which we know that they do not have.
Ladies and gentlemen, fasten your seatbelts.
They want me dead, I walk around like I don't care. I know that it isn't fair, I walk around like I don't care. All you ghosts dead meat, money, Micah Myers, walk like Friday the 13th. Black Ben, Black Clint, Black Kitten Crew. Lord, forgive me what I'm about to do. Give me what I should have did. I wish these niggas, they was dead. Fuck the devil's birthday. Ish, ah, la. It smells like a weed field. It's just my car.
Are you really related to Mark Wahlberg?
No, this is what happened. Okay, we both got invited to an Illuminati party, right? Only one of us can go. So I walk in the party, and then all of a sudden, Marky Wahlberg from the Funky Bunch is there too. I said, motherfucker, I thought only one of us can go. And then Leonardo DiCaprio comes out and he says, no, dude, you guys are both straight. So we're sitting there and all of a sudden he starts looking at my hairline. And he's like, starts cutting. He's like, you gotta shave this part of hair. I said, dude, I'm already fucking losing my hair. And he says, but I'll shave that part if you shave that part. And then all of a sudden he says, yo, you wanna do some movies with me? And I was like, yeah, I wanna do some movies with you. I'm a fucking big fan. I mean, you starred in several movies. Boogie Nights, The Fighter, Ted, Daddy's Home, Two Guns, Pain Game, all these motherfucking movies. And Robert De Niro comes up to me and he says, yo, Polly, let me just put my finger in your asshole. And I said, whoa, bro, only if you give me $200 million. And he said, I got you. So he said, he gave me $200 million, De Niro and Pacino and fucking Joe Pesci, put their finger in my asshole, I get escorted to leave, and the rest is history. The one dude made fucking 20 movies in a row, millions of dollars, and I got left by myself. One of those dudes is named Mark Wahlberg, from AKA Motherfucking Funky Bunch, and the other one is named Motherfucking Pauly Shore, and that's my story. And after this, I don't know what's gonna happen. I'm sure once this airs, all these people are gonna come after me, and I'm gonna wind up with Joe Rogan over at the mothership in Texas. Fuck. I need to get an Uber, because I am fucking wasted right now. Does anybody, can you call me an Uber out of here? Please, or a Lyft or something. You can't call me an Uber, please. Huh? What about my wife? Call my wife. Have my wife pick me up.
Polly, you don't have a wife.
Please, just come on. Help me out my seat, motherfucker. Yeah, shit. Yeah.
All right, you got it?
Don't fucking touch me, you fucking woke motherfucker. I'll kill you.
Come on.
I'd say don't motherfucking touch me, bitch.
Polly,
back the fuck.